Was this girl trolling a troll, or did she actually commit a hate crime? Let's talk about it.
Yeah, is this serious or silly? Let's run the clip.
The cheek, the dispo picture.
Yeah.
Three, two, one.
Hey. I don't remember your videographer.
Yes.
Can you give my friend Hayden here a kiss on the cheek for the poll? Oh, wow.
Oh, my God.
Oh, wow.
Really, what are you doing?
Damn.
Oh, wow.
And you're not funny.
Wow. Are you okay, Hayden?
Boom. So listen, man, as you can tell, it's not the hardest hit ever. But when you get into like the racial dynamics of it, Andrew, it had the internet feeling some type of way.
Yeah, no, and I think that's why it's fair that we got to talk about it, because it is an Asian guy who's getting smacked by a white girl who's wearing a MAGA hat. So essentially, Hayden Jeong is being featured on the streamer's channel.
He's a streamer.
He's also a streamer, but he's getting featured on their channel. They're out on Venice Beach. They meet some drunk white girls who are dressed in essentially MAGA gear. They have the MAGA hats, American all out, you know, blonde
and
girls.
And by the way, I do think that white guys who run Errico TV are more on the right side.
Right.
They're more Republican.
Right, yeah. And those guys are big, by the way. They're all like 6 feet tall. Hayden Jeong, he says, is a 5'5", I think he said himself. So he's a little on the shorter end, shorter than everybody else.
He physically looks like the odd man out.
Right. He's the only Asian guy there. Anyways, they say, oh, kiss my friend. He asked for a kiss. And instead of a kiss, the girl pushes his face and smacks him in the face, essentially. So here is Hayden Jeong's response on his channel after that alleged girl has reached out and sent an apology to him.
I don't get what she meant by "you're not from here" if it wasn't intended to be racist. In what way does "you're not from here" mean anything but a racially, you know what I mean? Like, what do you mean by "you're not from here" besides being racist? I could be wrong. And chat, tell me, if I'm wrong, let me know. Am I wrong? Or is that always a racist thing to say?
Boom. So listen, Andrew. Some non-Asian people, like even white people that are fans of Hayden Jeong, as well as Asian guys, when they found out about this, I'm sure, you know, I only knew about this incident because it got posted because of the racial dynamics, right? We're kind of mad that he let everybody off so lightly.
Here, essentially, the reaction is a lot of people are mad and saying that she did commit a hate crime because her comments at the end were racially fueled, it sounds like.
You're not from this country, B.
She says you're not from here, beach. So obviously, what does that mean? They're probably referring to race. Will the FBI count it as a hate crime? I don't know. But anyways, a lot of people are mad because an Asian guy got slapped. Or you could just say a guy got slapped for being rejected.
And some people are saying like he's appeasing the whites to like try to be cool. Or some people say he's just too young. He doesn't understand all the racial dynamics at play here. So we're going to try to get into it. Make sure you like, subscribe, turn on your notifications. Check out SmileSells at SmileSells.com. A lot of people were posting this saying, look at how I show speed gets so much love in Southeast Asia, but then look how Asian American streamers get slapped in the face for content.
Okay. I wouldn't really compare iShowSpeed to Hayden, but yes, for sure, iShowSpeed is getting a lot of love out on his Asia tour. That right, is right, for right. sure.
I mean, honestly, I think iShowSpeed, honestly, I could see why he's popular. Yeah. Like, he's super charismatic. Mm. But was Hayden just putting himself in a situation where this was very likely? Anytime the little Asian guy wants to hang out with the tall white baseball football bros or whatever they are, you know, and they're hanging out with all these like blonde chicks. They don't look like K-pop fan mm-hmm. blonde chicks.
Yeah.
You're put in a bad position right around all these, what, alpha blue collar people.
For sure. I mean, first off, I want to say this girl should not have slapped him. That is wrong for her. And she should get the internet's wrath. So be it.
Which
and
she
I
did.
Think, and I think she deserves it. Now, whether or not how serious this smack was, I think is debatable in my opinion. And this is my opinion as a guy who probably gets viewed sort of like Hayden Jeong. I mean, look at this picture of me and Hayden Jeong. We look kind of similar.
But you guys both look like trunks.
Yeah, maybe. Like who knows? Maybe you could say he's cuter than me. I don't care. Listen, that's not the point. He's younger, all right? He's younger and cuter, sure. But he essentially, I've been viewed as a Hayden Jeong before, and I've been in different situations. I've been at the white frat party. I've been around a bunch of drunk people, and I will tell you this, all right? If you are going into the situation as the odd man out, the person who is clearly different than other people. You're not as tall as other people. You're not the same race as other people. Guys, this is no mystery.
But would you say especially in these state frat school-like settings?
Yes, and especially you're out on the beach talking to drunk people, okay? And you're trying to ask for a kiss on the cheek from drunk girls who are wearing MAGA hats, of all people. Guys, these aren't Asian girls they asked for a kiss on the cheek. These were white women with MAGA hats. I'm not saying all people who wear MAGA hats hate Asians. I'm not saying that. But I'm just saying that if you made me guess, the likeliness of someone wearing a MAGA hat and being nice to an Asian is lower. So you're putting yourself in enemy territory. You're putting yourself in an uncomfortable position. And all I'm saying is you got to be ready for some stuff like this to happen. I'm not saying that it's justified. This was on the upper end of unacceptable behavior from her. So that's why she should get the wrath of the internet. But I'm just saying you are putting yourself in that position, bro.
Point number three, Andrew, do you think that it's true that Asians are often more shy or tend to deflect from conflict? Because a lot of people are saying that Haydn Jeong, at least at the moment, acted exactly how a lot of you would almost like expect a docile Asian to act.
Yeah, I mean, look, if you look at the freeze frame of the pictures, he gets smacked. And then he's just like, oh, he's holding his face. First of all, I don't think he was really hurt. But yeah, it was probably shocking. It shocked everybody.
And he probably was hurt because he felt rejected, right?
Yeah, and embarrassed. It is embarrassing. However, they're out with the cameras out. And, you know, I'm just saying, bro, if you're going to be a bold Asian guy and put yourself out there up to drunk people, my opinion, is that if you put yourself in that position where you're dealing with drunk people and you're trying to get content out of them and you got the big, bright lights, LED lights on your cameras shining in people's faces and people are drunk, you don't know how they're going to act. People say crazy and do crazy things when the cameras are out.
On their inner thoughts. And her inner thoughts were, I don't want to kiss this little Asian dweeb to me. So I'm freaking out. Yeah. Let me just go with a slap to the face.
Yeah, and I'm not sure if you would consider that assault, but it was a smack. It was a push with the five hands for sure. It was wrong. People shouldn't just get pushed like that for asking a question. But you're asking women to kiss you. Like, it's kind of like, you're kind of like out there in what I call a volatile situation.
Right. I mean, by the way, guys, I do believe that this girl is probably racist. And
sure.
I think it's fair that people look up her info and do whatever they need to do and, you know, whatever.
The wrath of the internet, as I said. She deserves the wrath from the internet.
So I'm going to get into some comments from non-Asians. They said, what the F? Most Asians people I've met in America are just so nice. He proves how chill he is by not overreacting, but I'm pissed off for him. So some people are like, he was being chill, right? So my whole thing is like, do you think he was being chill because he was powerless? Or do you think he was being chill because that is the right, like, I'm bigger than this situation response?
I don't know. I mean, I do think that getting hit in the face was surprising and shocking to everybody.
Yeah. Right. Obviously, people are saying that the internet trolled her and they forced her to delete all her social media accounts. So some people were like saying, let's pursue more and like dox her even more. But other guys were like saying, oh, nah, she already learned her lesson. It wasn't too big of a deal. And then somebody said, man, this guy, this is from a non-Asian, is being a little B. Stop smiling and pretending nothing happened. And why don't you stand up for yourself and sue her?
Stand up for yourself and sue her. I guess I'd like to know how that whole legal process is going to work and what the police are going to say or what the lawyer is going
to
say.
I will say this, though. If a guy did that to a girl, it's a case.
Yes, and we know why, because men and women are different, guys. And if you want to argue about that on our channel, I'm not going to have that argument with you. But I will say this.
I think if he legally wanted to pursue it, he has a case.
What's the case? What does he tell the cops? Let's say you call the cops. Hayden's on the phone calling the cops. He says, a lady just smacked me in the face. And the cops are like, all right, what happened? Well, we have our cameras out and we're on the beach and we're asking girls to kiss us on the cheek and she didn't want to, so she kind of smacked me in the face.
It's still assault, though. I'm not saying that he should, but I'm just saying legally he's within the bounds of like the law to file.
Is the FBI going to count this on the hate crime statistics against Asian Americans?
No, they're not. Because they're going to be saying that it's like, it's tough. Like you said, I think it's really clouded because this whole prank lane of channels and these sort of like very emotional, like playing it off everybody's like amygdala brain. You know what I mean? Like it's such like a trashy It's just such a trashy zone of the internet. So I see what you're saying.
That's why those big white guys who are like 6 foot tall get to go out and troll people and ask people for questions because they're not fearful of anybody. No one's going to mess with them. I'm just saying, if you, the smaller dude, and you going out there trying to be bold, talking to drunk people, and this is not a classroom, you're not on a college campus, you're talking to drunk people who are wearing MAGA hats. I think that matters because it kind of shows what how bold that they're trying to be.
No, these are hyper alpha, probably like uneducated, sort of like hillbilly redneck types, yeah. Like more towards that zone.
I don't think the case is that strong. And I feel bad that Hayden had to go through that, but also he got a lot of content and sympathy points for it. And being a streamer, I think he might even like it.
No, that's true. That's true. Let's get into the Asian guy breakdown of it. Somebody said, this is so sad. This happened to me when I was in high school, essentially when I was like trying to fit in with white people. So yeah. It conjured up a lot of images of people who like grew up in more, I guess, white suburbs, especially like I'm assuming like more middle class or lower middle class ones. But I guess this could happen in the upper middle class one, but less likely, where it's like you're trying to fit in with everybody. Uh-huh. So you're taking this lower status on the totem pole just to be part of that totem pole. Yeah.
I've been pushed in the face by a girl before for just being rejected. That's actually, so the smack is if someone pulls back and you know, cocks back their hand and really tries to hurt you, that's different. But I've gotten pushed in the, like you at the club, like people, the rejection, it happens. Like, so to me, this is not the hardest hit. I think it's disrespectful. It's highly disrespectful.
Yeah.
Highly disrespectful, but not.
I understand where you're coming from. I think there's two ways to look at it. I think if you look at Hayden Jang like a streamer, it's almost like, I don't care what happens to streamers. I don't care what happens to
pranksters.
I hate
this content. I hate this type of content.
But then on an Asian angle, it's like that takes the conversation to a whole different category. He says, he seems like the token Asian that lets his white friends walk all over him. His friends didn't even stand up for him. It's so sad. Yeah, it's true. They didn't. And it's like, I don't think a lot of people like the fact that in his video about it, he let them off the hook for not defending him. But at the same time, what are they supposed to do too?
What are they supposed to gang up on her and beat her up?
I'll tell you this.
Are you guys kidding me?
Those tall white guys do not see him as an equal. They do not care about him. No. And all the Asians who are stepping into this situation, you got to be sure your friends, they might see you as different, but they still got to see you as relatively equal. I know that a lot of Asians, it's like, there's all these cultures that are more socially deviant and crazier and viewed as more fun in society than ours. So we want to like adapt to them. And I get that because they see different things and they live different lives and they see different reps. But you have to have some level of self-respect for yourself. But here's the thing, Hayden Jang, I think he's really young. So he doesn't like, he's still got a lot of man life to grow into.
Sure. Yes.
But he's trying to be cool right now. He wants to be down with the frat boys.
And I think there's something to learn from this. I think there's something to learn from this, man. That's all I'm saying.
Right. Ultimately, here's the thing, man. Here's what I wanted to say. Like, I feel like it's an important incident for Asian guys to take a look at just to see how they would respond. But you can't control anybody's response. You know, some people, they want to like, you know, kind of suck it up and like turn lemon into lemonade. And you know, man, he's going to farm it for content. And eventually he's going to probably go get with some Asian chicks. Sort of like Rice Gum. Remember when Rice Gum was the only Asian guy, Andrew, who was with the Jake Pauls and Logan Pauls in that mm-hmm. world. And they used to talk down on him because he was Asian too. And then he got on Wildin' Out. And then I feel like Rice Gum's almost come, I don't want to say he's come back to the AZN like enclave world, but he definitely surrounds himself with more Asians as he got older. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because at a time when you're trying to get clout, you're willing to like take this like lesser role or like 1.5 second citizen status to fit in with the crowd that you feel like has all the juice.
Yeah, I agree.
And you're basically getting disrespected or taking a lower status points for the clout.
Yeah, I agree. Listen, I mean, I think that context is everything, and this girl deserves whatever wrath from the internet that she got. Hayden did not deserve to get slapped for being rejected. But if you walk out on the beach and put the camera on drunk people and ask them for kisses, I don't know. You're inviting a lot of different energy there. It might go upside. They might kiss you on the lips. They might give you their yeah. phone number and be like, oh, you're cute. Yeah. And then that'll be like great content too. You're like, oh my gosh, these white girls love me. And then, but also, you got to be ready for the disrespect. That slap was way beyond the level of disrespect that it needed to be, for sure. But expect to get rejected. You know what I'm saying? And I think that it's like when you walk up to a basketball court, like a open park, a park in New York City, and you see a bunch of like aggressive dudes playing basketball, right? They got Tims on, maybe, whatever. They just, there's a lot of contact going on. You're like, hey, I want to go play this game. And then you get fouled and you get smacked in the face. Maybe you get a bloody nose. Are you going to try to sue them? Do you call the cops? Do you stop the game? Do you leave the game? Or did you kind of step into that game knowing that there's a chance that might happen?
For sure. I mean, listen, guys, I wish that, you know, the way we want things to be, it could be that way. But like, I just feel like Asian guys, I wish we would just like reach out to each other, support each other more and build our own systems. So we wouldn't always have to be in this like playing the B-side position. Because when you are the little bro, or even like in certain situations, like the little bro, that is not an advantageous situation to make reads out of.
Hey, man, I've had my interactions with drunk white guys before, David, drunk white people, right? I'm not, we don't need to go into detail, but you got to learn your lesson, man.
Yeah, because
like, drunk people and of all races, I don't want to just only pin white people, by the way. Drunk people of all races can act erratic.
Right. I just think that generally drunk white people, they're more likely to pick on an Asian guy because they're probably too scared to confront, obviously, a black or a Latino guy, to be honest.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, at the end of the day, look, Hayden, his face is fine. He didn't get scratched. He didn't even get a bloody nose. Her nails didn't scratch him in the face. So really, did he get damaged? I don't know. But anyways, I would say this, guys. Again, just lesson for anybody who wants to go out in the real world and deal with drunk people and try to get content out of it. Got to be ready for some stuff.
All right, guys, let us know what you think of this incident in the comments section below. A lot of talk on the internet, a lot of arguing. Until next time, we're the Hot Pot Boys. We out.
Peace.